Welcome children to the next poem of our English class. A very beautiful poem. This poem is just for you to learn for fun. You can improve your vocabulary, you can learn the language. So learn it, repeat. When I read the poem, repeat it with me and learn all the words, how it is being pronounced and by heart it. Okay children, but understand it first. Okay, let's have some fun with the poem. The poem is My mirror likes to argue by Ken Nesbitt. The poet name is Ken Nesbitt. He has written a beautiful poem. So this poet Ken Nesbitt writes beautiful poems. His poems will be only for children. He has been given a laureate, children's laureate award. After that they have changed to young children's laureate. So the last person. Actually his poems are all about children. Very funny. Kind of you don't find any thing in that, like you know, where you enjoy the poem and there is no seriousness in the poem. And in a world where imagination goes, all of his many poems are there. I did not do my homework. Like all this poem will be about the children. If you want, you can Google this person's name and his poems. You'll find many poems on him. You can enjoy those poems. Read. So here, let's see. He's an actually American poet. Ken Nesbitt, an American children's poet. He writes poems specially for children. Enjoys writing. So he's an American. American children's poet. Okay, children. So normally, see, especially for children, he writes. You can find a lot of fun. Okay. So this particular poem, what it is called? My mirror likes to argue. You understand? Mirror. So here we are going to see how a child finds a friend in the mirror, in himself. And the fresh look, normally how to come out of this world where lot of seriousness is there. You have to think a lot. So here little bit a change in your life where you can enjoy within yourself, where you can find love, you can find fun within yourself. Let's enjoy. My mirror likes to argue. My mirror likes to argue. He likes to fight and feel. He often disagrees with me. He is regularly rude. He is fond of making faces. He loves to sneer and scowl. And if I scream and shout at him, he'll holler, hoot and howl. I wish I would never met him. I wish he would go away. I wish I didn't chance upon him several times a day. I think perhaps the next time he starts to disagree, I'll smile at him to see if maybe he'll be nice to me. Did you get me? No. Let's read one more time. My mirror likes to argue. My mirror likes to argue. He likes to fight and feud. The word feud. Okay, you pronounce feud. He often disagrees with me. He's regularly rude. He's fond of making faces. He loves to sneer and scowl. He loves to sneer and scowl. And if opposite to each other. Okay, so my mirror likes to argue. He likes to fight and feud. Here, fight and feud means quarrel. Say, my mirror likes to quarrel with me. Always fight with me, quarreling. Quarreling is called verbal, when you accuse with the words. Okay, that is called quarrel. He often disagrees with me. Disagrees, doesn't agree. Not whatever I say yes, he say no. That is called disagreement. He often means here, often means regular. Often means regular point. It happens. He often disagrees with me. He is regularly rude. Rude, you understand, where you really are not good to a person. Always very rude to me. He is regularly rude. He is fond of making faces. Many kind of faces. When you stand in front of mirror, whatever kind of faces you make, you see there. Different kind of faces. Happy, smiley, or frown, like angry, or teasing, or sad, or crying. Many kind of faces, or your emojis, what you send in your WhatsApps. You can. How many kinds of faces types you can make? So he is fond of making faces. He loves to sneer and scowl. That means shows anger on the face. So he loves to show anger on the face. Who? The mirror. He is complaining. The poet is complaining. The child is complaining that he likes to argue with me. He likes to fight with me. He likes to make angry faces. He loves something doing what? To sneer and scowl. To make anger on the face. He likes that. To show anger on the face. And if I scream and shout at him and seeing that anger face when our poet shout and scream at, what it is? He'll holler, hoot and howl. What does holler mean? Makes loud and angry shout. Even more than him, he shouts. He says, when seeing that angry face, when I shout and scream at, he'll also make such angry loud sounds at me. Okay. I wish I would never met him. I wish he would go away. This is the wish of our poet. I wish I would never met him. I wish I should have not seen him. I mean, he would go away. He would not be in front of me. I wish I didn't chance upon him. Yet chance upon him means met him by chance. Like I wish he's like every time he comes into the front of mirror, he has to see. So I wish I can't. I should not see him. But like the chances I get to see him, I don't get that chances to see him. Several times a day, not once, too many times in the day, many times I have to see him. So I wish I couldn't see him. He doesn't come into my, to me, in front of me. I think perhaps, here perhaps means maybe. I think perhaps the next time he starts to disagree, he says. So now the poet, he complains and perhaps the maybe if next time he disagrees in front of disagreement, doesn't agree with me making those faces, I'll smile at him to see if maybe he'll be nice to me. So our poet thinks this time if he's disagreeing, this time also he's making faces at me, I'll just smile at him. Let me see he'll also be nice to me or not. So this I'll a chance I'll take. So here actually this nothing but a imagination of a child who is standing in front of the mirror and making many kinds of faces and teasing himself. He says the mirror is arguing with me. So here our poet consider another, the mirror into another person. Okay, normally suppose you stand in front of your mirror. Whatever faces you make, even the mirror will see your image there. But here the poet for fun tells you that imagine and think that mirror is another character. Whenever I